First and foremost, I'm going to go over the two files that you usually see with FL Studio in terms of projects. We're going to have what is known as the FLP file. It'll be a file icon with the FL logo over it. And then you're going to see something called a .zip. This is going to be a compressed zip folder, as seen here. This is going to have all these stuff in it. And the difference between this and this, like I just said, is this is going to be an FLP file. This will search the destinations for certain sounds that you use within the program, where this one will have all these sound samples set into the folder. So if I double click this folder, notice we have 4, 5, 6 sound files, and then of course the FLP file. This is going to be useful when you want to send it to other people for working with. So if I open this up, notice I do have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sound samples. So if I just go ahead and click these real quick. So yeah, you see these are little waveforms. And then I have 3 generator plugins. One is from Citrus that comes with FL Studio. I have one from Harmer, or is this Harmless? Yo, baby girl. Harmless right here. And I have something known as from Native Instruments. So yeah, massive. And along with that, I also have in the effects, you know, just this one right here that says kick. There's one called Transient Master from Native Instruments. This is to give it air. But yeah, this right here, Transient and Massive, these won't be shown in another person's computer if they open up your zip file or FLP file in terms of, you know, if they don't have Native Instruments contact or, you know, the whole complete or just Massive and Transient Master itself. Of course, there's other plugins such as like Waves, if you have Waves in here, any third party stuff that you have that they don't, they're not going to see. So now that I thoroughly explained this to you guys and girls, I'm going to go ahead and show you first how to save. So yeah, go to File, Save As, and back. We get this, you know, Explorer, Save As. Where do you want to save? I'm going to go ahead and open up a bit. I'm going to select my desktop since it's there, and I'm going to name this 83toot zip. Or no, I'm going to take out the zip, 83toot. And this is going to be saved as a zip file. So if I hit save, pop, it's saved. If I were to go into my computer, my desktop, notice I have the 83toot file, tutorial file. And this is going to have everything here as well. If I were to have this file right here, which is pretty big, and I'm like, hey, I don't want this in my, you know, project. Let me delete that. It's still in FL Studio. If I go over here, select all, notice we have the Unlimited Tone Utate Sunshine song right here. I don't want to click it before copyright kills me. So if I want this out of my project, because look, if I go to save as and I, you know, save over my 83 tutorial, I'm gonna hit yes. Bop. Look, I have this big 9.184 MB, 8 MB, whatever, this big file inside of my project that I'm not even using. So what I'm gonna do is open FL Studio. Cool. Now I'm gonna show you 2 ways to open this. First and foremost, go to File, Open, look for this zip file, and go ahead and click Open. That's one way, but I don't really like going through that whole, you know, file open, go search for the file. If my file is on my desktop, guess what I'm going to do? I'm just go here, I'm going to take this zip file, drag it down to FL, and then I could just put it up here, and it will open. So notice it's, you know, reopening it. That's the way I like to open the project. So yes, back to this whole vocal stuff. You might have like a billion of these. Let me just clone this, I guess. Look, there's 2 of them and they're not in the project. We could go to something here, Tools, Marcos, and go to Purge Unused Audio Clips. What this will do is delete audio clips that is not being used in the playlist. The playlist is over here, but it's in the channel rack slash pattern list over here. So notice these 2 sounds right here. I'm going to purge them. Bop. They're both gone. They deleted off of it because it's not in the playlist. So what I could do now is go back to File, Save As, or just hit Control S at that point. I could go over here, hit Save. Yes. Cool. And now if I go over here back to 83, my bad for always dragging it over here. But yeah, notice the song Utate Sunshine Unlimited Tone is not here in this list. So that means you saved your space. You did what you're supposed to do. Now, one last thing before I go, I'm going to go ahead and show you guys and girls what you should do if you do not have this third party plugin, or if the other person doesn't have the third party plugin. So for example, I'm going to go over both the Kick and I'm going to go over Massive. The reason why I'm going through Kick again is because the transient master effect is applied, and the Massive because this is a generator that, you know, they probably won't have. So I'm gonna go ahead and mute or solo just the Massive so you can hear how that sounds. So yes, we're gonna have to do what is known as freezing the track, or otherwise known as rendering the audio. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and click down here, and I could do the same thing for the Kick. So by the way, let me just play the Kick. So notice the difference with the Transient Master. But yeah, what I want to do is go ahead and go down, like I said, down here to this button where it says Arm Disk Recording. I'm going to click it. And then once I have my tracks that I want frozen, clicked, and recorded, we could go ahead and go into this carrot over here, the top right, Mixer Options. Go to Disk Recording, Render, Two-Wave Files. I'm going to go ahead and click, and cool. Mode is going to be, what do you want, the full song? Do you want just the pattern over here? So yeah, I'm going to put full song because, you know, the full song. For the sound resampling, you could put it as, you know, as much as you want. The higher you go, the better quality it is, but the longer it might take to export. And then these, I already explained them like a billion times. Just select those. And yeah, I'm going to hit start, bop, and then it's going to export these audios or render these tracks. And bop, bop, notice these are in the playlist. So if I go ahead and right click, only play this one. So notice the wave file for the Kick became its own thing. We could just go ahead and cut this, cut, and then copy and paste if we want to have another section. So yeah, Control B. Yeah, notice how that works out. But just know the audio files for both the Kick and the Massive is here. This is going to be how you want to freeze your tracks and save as a .zip.